I think everybody has to have something, you know. I think whether, you know, whether you have a child with a disability or not, you know, what I do know is I know I need something to go do that's just my time. So mine's I like to go and do some sort of physical activity. I'm pretty religious about it.
What did I do to decompress? Well, as you can tell from this Olympic body of mine, physical exercise was my mantra.
You get out of the house, you go do some exercise, you go talk to your friends, give them a call, have a chat with them.
I drank too much. I tuned out whatever possible way I could find to tune out. At the times I was allowed to tune out.
You know, the first 2 or 3 years, there's a lot of nights where you'd sit at home and you'd pour yourself a double, two fingers, and you'd just sit and think and wonder, and how's this going to work out? And what am I going to do here?
I think it is still very much very difficult for people outside to really understand what it's like dealing with someone, particularly with some of the more severe aspects of behaviour, with someone with autism. So I think when a child has issues with disabilities, the issues are there. Maybe they get to put a label on it and make the diagnosis, but it still doesn't change things. And still the same child. It just in some ways probably makes it a little bit easier to understand.
But yeah, don't follow my example. Go out, have a run. It's really good for you. Do that. I like walking now.
Cycling. Yeah, I like riding my bike. It prepares me mentally for work. So riding my bike is probably my time where I'm allowed to think and we're allowed to relax. Yeah, that's how I cope.
I think physical exertion is also, you know, a big positive. You try and take what you're given and help it benefit you. You hope that those difficult times make you better. And, you know, I ran a lot.
Personally, my outlets are sports and physical activity. So often, this often happens after kids go to bed. So I'm a keen sports person. So at the moment, I'm into rock climbing. So try to do that twice a week, go for a run. Exercise, it tends to work a lot. Like, it just relieves the stress because you're releasing all your stress out on the rock rather than on something else.
On a bad day, stillness is pretty rare and hard to find in most families. But I found if I could just get 15 minutes of quiet, that would be very therapeutic to sort of just resettle everything.
A rough day is sometimes one of you just walking away and letting the other, who has the most energy on the day, take care of Max.
One of the blokes that I live with at the moment, Harrison, I remember he would just call me up and just say, let's go play golf. Let's just go play golf. Let's just go have a surf. And we wouldn't talk about anything specifically. You talk about the footy, you talk about the weekend, you talk about this person, that person, but I needed to be away. I needed to be occupied. I needed to be thinking about something else.
Reassure yourself with the knowledge that there are better days ahead. And at the end of the day, it's the child that needs you to keep going and keep it all together.
Throw yourself into work. I've also found is for the really hard times in life, work can be good. Get your mind on something else, and then come back to it. And that, I think that's how I tuned out. But I was lucky enough to be able to tune out because there were other people around me shouldering the burden. So I appreciate the times you're allowed to tune out because that usually means somebody's not.
But in the back of your mind, I think, again, parents with kids on the spectrum, they're a hardy bunch, and you sit there and you think, not, oh, woe is me. It's, okay, how am I going to climb this mountain? And, you know, left foot, right foot, get going.